Peace and blessings, YouTube. What's good? What's good? As you know, I got a little job or whatever, and in my department that I work in, there's a lot of different coffees and teas from around the world. So I want to start making some YouTube videos about, like, different teas, different coffees, their properties, their tastes, you know, just so you could be more familiar with the things that's out there. But first of all, before we go any further, I'd like to talk about the difference between tea and tisane. Some people also say it as tisane. You can roll that window up, please, baby?
Sure.
Yeah, so tisane, thank you.
Yeah.
Tisane is different from tea. What is tea? Tea basically has caffeine. Tea is stuff like black teas, your Earl Greys, those flavored teas you always get from Lipton's. Those are teas, traditional teas. But then you have something called tisane or tisane. Those are things like peppermint, spearmint, lemongrass, rooibos. People say, what's rooibos? I heard that before. I'll tell you about that later. Hibiscus. These are tisanes. These are not really teas. They're actually just herbs or leaves or fruits or berries that people use in conjunction with hot water to bring forth a good taste and a good effect. These are the things that happens when you put good stuff in a cup. You know what I'm saying? Is it true or false? You put good stuff in a cup, good things happen, right?
True. And the Chinese use bohe.
Bohe?
Bohe is peppermint.
That's my wife. My wife said bohe is peppermint. Tell me about, what's that, zhang bao? What is that? Tell me about the guano.
Oh, you mean it's bat poop.
Can I put you on camera?
No. My wife don't want to be on camera.
Huh?
Bat poop, right? Bat poop, yes. And it's called Yemingsha. Yemingsha. They're all three different words.
And what does it do?
Yemingsha. It's bat poop, and it helps with blood stasis. And what else does it do? I think that's the one that helps with cataracts. It does things for the eyes, because what that herb does is it works with the liver channel. You understand? Mm-hmm. So that's why it helps with the eyes, because the eyes are affected by the liver, the energy from the liver.
The eyes are affected by the energy from the liver.
Yes.
You see, my wife is very knowledgeable. I'm very blessed to be with her. It's funny because she's studying in a, what's the word? She's studying in a didactic format. So she goes to school, she learns from the pedagogy, which is the learning institute. And I'm more of a freestyler, you know, I just study what I want to study. I study Hare Krishna, I study Bhagavad Gita, I study the Vedas, Ayurveda, I study Yoruba, Ifa, Vudun, I study it, or whatever meets my fancy at the moment. But what I realized when I got with my wife was that the information I'm studying about, which is basically serpent science, the science of the serpent, she's studying that stuff already, but she calls it acupuncture. And when you're dealing with the science of the serpent, what you're dealing with is the unity between heavens and the earth. Because as you know, the earth has a certain charge of energy, and the heavens have a certain charge of energy. And when they exchange that energy, that's when you get closer to what we call divinity. So this is all serpent science. My wife is learning how to manipulate basically the nadis and the channels of the body. You know, like if your energy flows in one way in your chakras, that's going to close the drawbridge. But if it flows the other way, it's going to open the drawbridge. So what my wife does, she's a chi bender. She manipulates the chi in your body. And she's also studying all of these ill Chinese herbs that you could only find in Flushing or in Chinatown. So, you know, not only are we looking forward to material prosperity, but there's a measure of spiritual growth involved in our relationship as well. And as soon as I get my own phone, I'm going to be back on, y'all. I'm going to be doing videos all the time. Don't worry. There's plenty of information. I'm still meeting the most amazing people on the planet Earth. And just go enjoy a good cup of tea. Now, for the Hare Krishna devotees out there, I'm understanding that tea and coffee tends to fall under the category of Raja food, R-A-J-A, which is the mode of passion. So I like to let you know that in my job where I work, there's a whole lot of teas that don't have caffeine. They're not even decaffeinated. They didn't have caffeine to begin with. And those are categorized as tisane or tisane. So, well, Hare Krishna people or anybody who wants to devote their food to the Almighty, you don't want to offer, like, you know, meat or anything with blood in it. anything that's been killed, any, you know, anything that's basically in a negative mode. So you want to offer foods to the creator that are drug-free, stimulant-free, just pure foods. And with that, I like to say peace and blessings. See you soon. Some Man Pato, King of YouTube, out.